I remember one time, Dawn and I were upstairs, and I was bugging him. And I always antagonized him, bugged him, so that, you know, I'd get some reaction out of him. And, of course, I got a reaction, and he pushed me on the bed. I mean, you know, he just pushed me on the bed. Well, I went on the bed, I rolled over, threw myself off the other side, hit the wall, made a big sound, "Mom, Mom, Donnie's hurting me." And then she yells up, "Donnie, quit hurting your little brother."
See? See? That's the way it's been all my life, man, that was right? So much now fun. The truth be told, right? Oh.
Like a comet blazing across the evening sky, gone too soon. Like a rainbow fading in the twinkling of an eye, gone too soon. Shiny and sparkly and splendidly bright, here one day, gone one night. Like the loss of sunlight on a cloudy afternoon, upon a sandy beach, gone too soon. Like a perfect flower that is just beyond your reach, gone too soon. A sunset dying with the rising of the moon.
Speaking of teenagers, when I was a teenager, I caused my brother a lot of grief.
Oh, did you ever? One day he told me, you know what he told me one day? He come to the store and he was so mad at you. He said, "That damn brother of mine," he said, "if it wasn't for him, I would have a good life." Oh, yeah, he said, "if it wasn't for him, my life would be good." When you didn't want to go to school there.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my. See, the Marcel Scaillis, he'd phoned Don. He'd say, "Your brother wasn't at school today," or something. So Don, but...